Wade over here from Service Plate Sports. It's an antique dealership in Fenton. So tell me, so what would you want to look for when you're buying an antique? Personally, you know, I'm a guy that likes to wait for it and serve. And I'm looking for an antique to buy. Okay, so what would you recommend for those people?
Well, we've got a couple different styles. Okay. We've got the 210 and 230. Okay. A great way for the turtle. Okay. 210
and 21
foot here. Okay. 230 over here. That's a 23-foot boat. They both have some additional bow, which comes to a point.
Okay.
And they look more like the, you know, boats of older style. And they work very, very well for what they're designed for. They've got great weight for the wake morning and a really good weight for surfing.
Okay.
But generally, more is better.
Yeah.
So a lot of people, you know, customers like to take a lot of their friends and families.
Yeah.
So we've got the G-Series boats, which we have here in a 21 and 23 footer. And they have a much larger capacity to hold more balance.
Okay.
A much larger boat to carry more people. So you're looking at a boat to carry 15 people or 18 wheels.
Okay, so the 25 is the one that holds like 18, right?
Yeah. And also like 324. Well, okay. Now that's also both the wakeboard boat, but it also has the ability to steer comfortably.
This is actually the Nautique 200. That boat's been causing me to ask a lot of questions.
The 200?
Yeah.
Okay.
It's obvious you're not here because it just came out.
Right there.
Oh!
Yeah.
Mind if we go take a look at that?
Let's go right over here. Sure.
Okay.
Actually move a lot like what we have on our wake surfing boat. You know, they're just
So this has the micro tube inside, right?
Correct.
So could you explain to our viewers what
those do? They automatically deploy at 28 miles an hour, or you can manually deploy them at different speeds. I'm sure at 28 miles an hour, 36 miles an hour, and it rotates programs at 28 off. What they do is they cause the trough literally behind the boat. You get the up here, and then you come down, and then you have the center part of the wake. What that does helps fill in the trough area on there, so you have very little bump to go across. And you're cutting across the wake and accelerating towards the buoy over there, you don't get that bounce on your ski, so you can stay in the center control for a higher traffic.
Well, that's all my questions. Do you want to say anything else?
Come see us at Silver Spray.
All right, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Yes, it's going.
So I am now interviewing with Whitney from Silver Spray. She does like all stuff for like wakeboards and everything. Basically all the accessories that you need. Her, you need an artist that you like. Tell us
what you like. What? So one thing that's super exciting that is new for us. Brian Versa. So pretty cool. It's like a knee board, wake skates, wakeboard, water skis, kind of all in one. It's got multiple attachments. These are all removable, so you can ride it all different ways, and it's great for everybody in the family. Everybody can use it.
So like if I was to do like wakeboarding school or something like that, it would be cool. Then this would be so what is this thing here?
So this is basically just a float, so great for when you're sitting at the sandbar when you're not geek and you're just having a good time and want something to float on. So it's called the water saddle, and you just put it in between your legs and sit on it, and you can float for hours with it. They come in all different colors too.
So this is a knee board, I'm guessing, right? Like a straight up knee board?
Yep, just old school basic knee board. They haven't changed in years, but they're still a lot of fun.
Okay. So, in terms of water, so, you know, I'm a guy. Come on, is it in selfie mode?
Yeah.
Camera?
No, it's not.
So, I'm a guy that is thinking heavily to get back into the water ski game. I've been wakeboarding for the past 2 years, and I really, really want to get back into skiing. Now, I got to ski on ski. And all that, so I want to get back in. So Whitney, I want to get back into skiing again. I weigh 145 pounds, and I want to take it easy. What would be good for me?
So you can obviously start off with a great pair of combo skis. I would recommend probably like a 63 or 67 inch. That kind of depends on what you need.
Okay. Now, in terms of clubs, so I know they have a lot of recommend on starting off with a pair of gloves?
It's personal preference. It obviously makes your hands hold up a lot longer. It gives you a better grip,
okay.
But it's not necessary if you're just getting back in the
game. So if you were gonna like get up into special skiing,
you know,
like would this be like a good start off if you were getting into professional skiing?
Learning the course and working your way that way.
Okay. Now, I noticed that you have a couple of these small wake boards here. So, what are these specifically?
This is actually our wakeboard bench. These are like original old school wakeboards. These are super, super old boards, and obviously when you are in the water sports, you end up with a ton of old equipment and you just don't know what to do with it. So we like to repurpose it and turn it into benches.
So these are actual wakeboards,
those
right?
Are actual wakeboards from like 15 years ago.
Wow.
Probably longer than that.
But
they've got that bench has been around forever.
Okay.
This thing.
So now we're on to what I like to do best, which is wakeboarding.
You can explain wakeboarding pretty well. This is what you're into.
Yeah.
So these are just some newer style wakeboards. It goes by weight. It's a big thing, and depends to determine what size you need. As far as bindings go, you can go with open toe or closed toe.
Okay.
It's really closed toe is going to be more size specific to your shoes, so it's going to be maybe a little bit more control, but other than that, it's really personal preference. If you're sharing boards with a bunch of family members, then we recommend open toe because it's going to be a little bit range of size.
So like I just putz around, on the lake when I'm wakeboarding. So what would be a good wakeboard to start off with if you want to do tricks and stuff?
All of the brands have great wakeboards as far as intermediate level boards go.
Okay.
I recommend always going with an intermediate level board. Don't get a real low end beginner board.
Okay.
Because you're not going to be a beginner forever, right?
Okay.
Hopefully you will become an intermediate rider in a matter of no time. So,
okay.
Getting at least an intermediate level board, and the big thing is just getting one that's the correct size for your weight.
So pricing. Because I got a lot of wakeboarders on my channel.
Awesome. It's all across the board. Typically, you're going to be, $500 for an advice setup, which would be probably the average range. You can obviously find them more, and you can go crazy, and they can be a lot more than that.
Okay. So what about multi-purpose knee board? How much does that go for?
That is, I believe, $250. So it's a great option because it's not super expensive, and you can get everybody in the family involved in the water sport.
I might buy one. So I really want to get into surfing. So what should I look for? Because when I bought my surfboard, I just went willy-nilly and just bought whatever was on your shelf.
In the store we have a huge selection of wake surfers to choose from. So for a beginner board, you're looking for something that's longer. The more surface area you have, the more buoyant it's going to be, the more weight it will hold. So it's going to be better for everybody to learn on, regardless of your size and weight. So typically what I recommend, there's two styles of wake surfers. There's surf style or there's skim style. It really just depends on what you want to do with the board and what you want to learn.
Okay, so a lot of people want to know, what are these life jackets? How is it different compared to, say, the life jackets that you would wear on a regular boat?
So these life jackets up here are not Coast Guard approved.
Okay.
So they are not actually legal in the state of Michigan. But use at your own risk.
Okay.
They're obviously much more comfortable. They are not going to be as buoyant, but they provide a lot of flexibility. So you can move around a lot better.
Okay. So how are you able to sell them if they're pretty much illegal?
So they're not illegal.
Okay.
When you are allowed to wear them on the water and when you are not allowed to. They are not legal on would you want to check with your state laws as well as the your lake laws, because all lakes are different as well. Sometimes they can have different resources.
Okay, so these are basically just for pure water sports, right?
Yeah.
Nothing else.
Correct.
Okay, well, is there anything you want to make it difficult for?
No, I don't think so.
Alright, thank you very much.
Thank you.
So I'm here with Jeff, the owner of the dealership. So can you tell us where we can find you guys if you want to buy one of these boats?
Right here in Detroit. We're at the Detroit Boat Show, but any other time you can come to Fenton and we can test drive boats and have a ball.
Thank you.